हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन सब्जेक्ट वर्ब अग्रीमेंट. सो द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव फॉर सब्जेक्ट वर्ब अग्रीमेंट इज आइडेंटिफाई द सब्जेक्ट एंड वर्ब इन द सेंटेंसेस. यूज द करेक्ट फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब इन द सेंटेंसेस. सो लेट्स रीड. सब्जेक्ट एंड वर्ब्स मस्ट अग्री विथ वन अनदर इन नंबर, सिंगुलर और प्लूरल. It means that if the subject is singular, then we need to use verb also in singular form. If the subject is plural, then we need to use verb also in plural form. If a subject is singular, its verb must also be singular. If a subject is plural, its verb must also be its verb must also be plural. For example, here you can see she works hard. Nobody is allowed to go out. So when I say she works hard, she is singular subject third person. So with singular third person subject, we use s or es with main verb. So that's why here it's written she works. If in place of she it's written I, so it should be I work hard, they work hard. So according to the subject, verb also should be used in that form. Nobody is allowed to go out. So nobody is singular. Nobody is a word. Nobody, somebody. So these words should have singular verb. So that's why it's written nobody is allowed. Now there are few rules which we need to follow while reading subject verb agreement, while learning subject verb agreement. So there are few words which are written here: anyone, everyone, each, either, neither, someone, no one, nobody. So after neither it should be a comma. Are always singular and therefore require singular verbs. So all these words are singular, so that's why we use singular verb with these words: anyone, everyone, each, either, neither, no one, no, nobody. For example, here you can see everyone has done his or her homework. So everyone is a singular word or subject, you can say. That's why we have used has. Has is singular form. Now the next one is verb in present tense for third person singular subject. For example, he, she, it, or any singular name. For example, Jack. Jack is singular name. So with all these singular third person subject, he, she, or any singular name, we have to use s form, or we need to add s with the main verb. Other verbs do not add s ending. For example, if I say he likes, so he is singular third person, that's why with like I have added s. She likes, she is also singular third person, so that's why I have used here s. But if I say they is plural, so that's why if we are writing plural subject, even I, we, you or any plural subject, or any plural name, for example children, so it should be children like, they like, I like, you like. So according to the subject we need to use verb also. Now the third rule is we use singular verb with uncountable nouns. So if any uncountable noun is there, with that we use singular verbs. For example, water. Water is uncountable. So water is essential for living. If I say sugar, sugar is, salt is, hair is. So all these uncountable nouns will take singular verbs. So these are the rules. I hope you have understood. So there are a few exercises to clarify the meaning or what we have just read. So just let's read it. Identify the correct verb in the sentences. So here these two options are there, and the correct answer I have marked in red color. I have highlighted here. So the people is plural subject, so that's why we will use verb is plural verb. If in place of the people he is there, so he was, but people is plural subject, so that's why it's written here the people were silent when the judge spoke. Now the second one is Gracie. Gracie is a singular name, singular third person you can say. Gracie is a singular name, and that's why we have used here S with write. So write is main verb and it will end with S. So Gracie writes interesting stories. In place of Gracie, if it is written I, so it should be written like this: I write interesting stories. Now the third one is neither Sam nor Tom. So here neither, as I have just explained, that neither is singular subject. So with that we always use singular verb. So neither Sam nor Tom. So here I'm saying it means that nobody, neither Sam nor Tom, was present at the meeting. Now the fourth one is many of the students. Here many of the students, that means we are talking about plural subjects. So many of the students have come late to class today. So if I say only students, if I say only students, then also it's plural. So students have come late to the class today. If I say he is singular third person subject, so with that we'll use has form, that means singular verb. So if in place of a students it's written he, so the sentence would be like that: he has come late to the class today. So I hope you have understood. Now just a quick revision, that if the subject is singular, then verb should also be singular. If the subject is plural, then verb should also be plural. So subject and verb always agree with one another. So thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you have understood and liked it, and share, also subscribe to my channel for more updates. Thank you so much for watching.